3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
Welcome to Roots of Reality. I'm your host, Ben Baumann, and today I'm going to be talking about Phase 10, the Christianization of the Roman Empire. So this story begins about 2,000 years ago in the Middle East when a man named Jesus of Nazareth was born in the Roman Empire. Before we begin this story, though, we must first clarify something, and that is the question of whether Jesus actually existed in the first place. Based on scholarly consensus, it is considered most likely to be true that Jesus did exist. The best evidence to date suggests he was there, and we have multiple sources besides biblical sources that referred to him, which is why scholars in the first place think he did exist. So with that out of the way, who was Jesus? Jesus was a Jewish man who, after meeting John the Baptist, who baptized him, would go on to be a preacher himself of Judaism. And this would happen when he was about 30. And his preaching would start to cause a fair amount of controversy due to the fact that a lot of the things that he preached were actually contradicting a lot of what mainstream Jewish preachers thought. And this did not sit well with local Jewish leaders, who were upset by his statements and thought he was actually pretty radical. Because Jesus was not really a popular figure in the Jewish world at the time when he was preaching. He was considered pretty strange and radical, and his ideas were considered not normal for the Jewish community at the time. And because of this, Jewish leaders started to become increasingly annoyed by Jesus. Despite this, though, Jesus became very popular with the poor, especially, and was incredibly welcoming and inspiring to them, and told them about the fact that heaven awaits them if they followed God and if they love each other. And this is very important to note because during this time, life was very hard, especially if you're poor, and there are way more poor people than rich people. The wealth was controlled by only a few, and many were suffering from not only poverty, but disease, and this was quite common. So as a result, his ideas and the fact that he reached out to people that weren't really preached to and that were actually kind of ignored in society, this led him to develop a loyal following, and it gave these people that didn't really have anyone speaking to them hope and something to live for. However, as Jesus started to gain a following, his preaching became more and more radical for mainstream Jewish leaders, and he became more critical of Jewish practices and of Jewish priests, which caused him to be disliked even more by the Jewish elite. And this was especially true when it came to the leader of Judaism, Caiaphas, who was a Roman appointed leader. And thus, because Jesus upset Caiaphas, he also upset the Romans who appointed Caiaphas in the first place. And as a result, Jesus was interpreted not only as a threat to the power of the Jewish leader, but also the Roman Empire, which chose Caiaphas as the Jewish leader. So this ultimately would lead to Jesus' execution by the Roman Empire. And after his death, he would later be considered by his followers to be God. And these beliefs would eventually become what is known today as Christianity. And his loyal followers would then go on to spread Christianity across the empire, while simultaneously the Christian message became less and less like Judaism over time, as it became less strict and was adopted by some non-Jews as well. While Jesus was alive, though, it is important to point out that the concept of Christianity actually did not exist yet. What he was preaching was considered to be Judaism, so only later did Christianity develop. And at the same time, neither Jesus nor his followers that knew him referred to him as God. So that was not something that would happen until later after his death. And later Christians would start to call him God. Another important factor when it comes to understanding the origins of Christianity was that at the very beginning after the death of Jesus, Christianity was not very popular at all. It remained quite small, and it did not grow and develop lots of followers until years after Jesus' death, and it started to grow thanks to followers of Jesus like Paul, but often the faith was persecuted by Roman rulers and often discriminated against. Later, however, this would all change, because a man named Constantine the Great would emerge victorious in the Roman Civil War and become the emperor of the Roman Empire. And this would be about 300 years after Jesus was born. And all of a sudden, everything would change tremendously for Christianity. Because Constantine would claim that his success in the Civil War was due to the Christian God. And he believed he was chosen by God to be the ruler of the Roman Empire. And from here, Constantine would work on Christianizing the Roman Empire, and he would use his authority to force a unified Christian tradition, because at the time, not only was Christianity's following quite small, but also it was very fragmented. There were lots of different Christians, but they didn't believe in the same thing. And so Constantine wanted to bring these Christians together and force a unified tradition of Christianity. That way, he could have an empire that was unified with one Christian tradition that he could be in control of. And so, for Constantine to bring about this version of Christianity that he wanted, and he did this by oppressing and discriminating against paganism. So ironically, Roman pagans, much like the Christians of the past, were being discriminated against and oppressed. And in the year 313, Constantine would make Christianity the official religion of the Roman Empire. And after that, in the year 325, this is when he would unify the Christian tradition by creating the Council of Nicaea, where Constantine had Christian leaders come together to agree on one single interpretation of Christianity. Thus, from here on, Christianity would continue to grow in popularity through the powerful and incredibly influential Roman Empire. And as a faith, it would continue to be spread after the fall of the Roman Empire by Europeans, and they would spread it all over the world, especially during the periods of globalization and colonization, which allowed it to eventually become the most popular religion in the world today. So amazingly, Christianity really just started with a small group of followers, and miraculously over time, it would go on to be followed by billions of people today, reminding us of just how important history is to understanding why the world is the way it is today. Thus, as always, remember, 13.8 billion years led to you, so make the most of it.